Hey everybody, welcome back to Jamia's Promo. Today we will be unboxing, setting up, and taking a look at the Linxdot Helium Hotspot. Now the Linxdot Helium Hotspot, there's not too many of them online at this moment. This is one of the first, 160, 170 units. Now if you guys are interested in the Linxdot, I will be placing a link below the video inside of the description. That'll give you a 3% discount, so it'll save you 3%. On this unit just by clicking the link below and or using the promo code Jimmy3. So inside the box here will be the quick start guide, and really it's super simple to get these things set up. You really just want to find the best location for the hotspot. You want to locate all the three main areas, which is the area for your antenna, your Ethernet if you like to sync faster, as well as the power. Download the application of the Helium Hotspot app, and then you go through the steps to get it all set up. And I get this question quite a bit, which is, we have multiple hotspots. Do they all have to be on the same account? Can they be on different accounts through different Helium applications? And you can put them on whatever account you want. It doesn't matter if you have 100 or 30 or 200 hotspots on one account. It really doesn't matter. These will not perform any different. They're not going to talk to each other. More specifically, if they are in the same, you know, group on an application, it's all based on where they are located. So this one right here is just a little bit larger than what I'm used to, you know, versus the Bobcat, versus the original Helium Hotspot Miner. This one's going to be just a little bit bigger, and there is a few upgrades to this unit as well when it comes down to the internal storage, the antenna, as well as the processor that's in there. So on the back is going to be the area for your radio frequency for your antenna. Here's the settings button. You have your LAN for your Ethernet. Again, you can do this either Wi-Fi or through your LAN, which if you do it through Ethernet, it will sync faster, it'll have a better connection, and less likely to get out of the current block. Here's micro USB if you need to do any type of updates or do whatever, and then as well as your power input, so the DC in. So what we're going to do today is we will get this thing connected. I will not be putting it to a location yet because at this house here, I am all maxed out, cannot put another hotspot in this location. So all I got to do is just find a new location, but we will get it connected today. So this way it can at least sync up. And then we will be adding the location later, which will also bring us another video in just a couple weeks. I will post another video on the 2 week, you know, review or the 2 week earnings of this hotspot, just to make sure that everything is looking good. The provided antenna is doing a great job, which this one right here is 3 dBi. Even though it is a little bit shorter than the majority of all the ones that I've seen as well, I think this one's even a little bit shorter than the one on the original OG Helium Hotspot. Now, before we get this one all connected, set up, and everything else, let's do take a look at where you can purchase this. Again, this will be the link provided in the description below where you're able to save 3% on your purchase, or use the code Jimmy3, and you can share that with all of your friends and family and everywhere else. But we're going to take a look here at the website. So here it is, store.linxdot.com. Now, make sure that you're taking a look at this store or using my specific link, so this way you know that it is not one of those fake scam websites. So this is the website right here. Now this one is going to be in the British pounds, and if you're curious on how much this is in US dollars, as of right now it's $536, but there is many different versions that they have for frequencies, and it's all done with this one website. So you have this one right here for the 915 for United States AS. You also have the 868 megahertz, which is for the EURU, and then you also have this other one down here, the 915 for Australia. So there's a bunch of different countries that is supported right here on this one website. Now shipping is late January 2021. You can take debit cards, credit cards, and crypto as long as they are the ERC20 only. Now we're going to go down just to take a look at some of the important specifications here. So you can see the size of the dimensions is going to be a little bit bigger than some of the other ones that you would see, but it does look actually really nice. And there is some mounting slots on the back. So if you wanted to mount this up onto a wall, you'd also be able to do that. Now the system on ship right over here is going to be a Raspberry Pi, but it has the quad core CPU at 1.5 gigahertz. I've seen a lot of them that were usually right around 1.3, 1.2. For the connectivity, you got your Bluetooth 5.0. This is the low energy powered one, so it's really nice. 1 gigabit per second Ethernet slot. Here's your Semtech SX1302. Now this right here is that chipset that's really been, you know, back ordered, and this is the thing that is the chip shortage, is this portion right here, making all of these hotspots super hard to get or long wait. Now it comes with a 3 dBi antenna, also the SPSMA female connector, which allows for the future upgrades and outdoor enclosures. Radio frequencies is going to be your EU, RU, US, AS, and then also does come with a universal power supply. So whichever one you purchase would come with the power supply that you would need. And really, that's pretty much about it here for this website. Now I do want to go to the Helium Explorer application. You can see that there's 206,000 that are online right now. There is 21 makers, that are included in all of this. So you got your Helium Inc., Calchip, Nebra, Synchrobit, Bobcat. So we're going to take a look over down here at Linxdot. You can see here that there's only 165 that are online, 129 that had the asserted locations. So when it comes down to it, this is one that there's not too many of. I mean, there's 23,000 cents cap. When you scroll up for Rack Wireless, there's over 1,000. Carolink, there's 641. Bobcat, there's over 82,000. Bobcat, Synchrobit, there's over 5,000. Nebra has over 11,000. Over 62,000 from Calchip. And again, here we are with this one right over here with only 165. So, you know, super glad and stoked that we have it here in the YouTube studio for us to get it connected and for you guys to take a look at it. So that's pretty much all we got to look at on the computer. So there we are, all plugged in. We do have the Ethernet cable. Here is the antenna. We also gave it the power supply. Now, the only thing that I'm going to, you know, again, let you guys know is that we will not be setting up the location, just because the fact that I can't put another hotspot here at this house. So we will be moving this to a different location. So it was actually pretty fun seeing these lights, you know, turn on and turn up. So I don't know if you can really tell, just because I have so much lights that's beaming down, but this is actually kind of a yellowish color that is blinking. Now, it's my understanding that there should be another indicator light popping on. So I think one of these may, there it is, should be turning blue, which is letting you know that it's ready to be synced. So from here, what you want to do is head inside of your plus button so you can choose which hotspot you will be adding. Then you just want to scroll down to where you see Linxdot. Now, once you tap on Linxdot, it's just letting you know, just to give it a good view, keep away from bug screens. So really the best place for this one's going to be basically at a window as high up as possible. So just go through here, understand, it's already powered up, and it already has the blue light that's ready to go. Let's see, scan for hotspot. Once it finds a hotspot, you tap on that one. And also too, because I'm not doing location in this portion of the video, the best thing to do I can give, you know, as a tip is to have this one set up when you type in the address. So sometimes your phone has the location based and you can just tap and go on from there, but it's always best to actually type out the address of where it's at so it can be more accurate. And sometimes if you don't type the address, you only picked up the location from your phone, depending on the phone, there could also be issues. So with this one here, you can choose one of these. Then you want to type in the password for the Wi-Fi, but here we are, we will be using Ethernet instead. We're going to ask for a permission. Actually, we're going to set this one up later. That was for the locations portions. So this is where now you want to register the hotspot. And once this thing is getting registered, and you see the screen pop up, which says go to wallet, that means that it is registering it for you already. When you go back into the wallet, then it's going to show you inside of this transactions page. And I guess I can show it right here. I'll just blur out that little spot down there, but it says hotspot added to blockchain. So it says pending. Now, if we did add a location, then you will see a second pending location right up over here, letting you know that you've added the location. And usually the hotspot added to blockchain will go through and finish first. Then the location will be added later on. And it might not even show location right away, but it will be popping up. Just give it a little bit of time. Again, if you do it through Ethernet, it'll always be faster. So that's really it. We just got this thing all set up. We've already added it onto the blockchain. We have this thing sitting right here. And now these lights are blinking basically kind of yellow. Let me see if I can turn off the studio lights. So I think this is just a little bit easier to see these colors right up over here. So you got blue, and then you're going to have these ones over here that is showing yellow. It's not really a green color yet. I believe once it turns green, then you know that you are good to go. And it's probably going to be this spot here. So again, this is going to be something for the future video where I let you know how it's done for 2 weeks, just to see if any of these colors has changed. But this right here is the Linxdot Helium Hotspot Miner. You know what? It's a pretty good setup. This thing is actually really super light. It's made of, I believe, ABS plastic, so it's not going to be heavy at all. It's going to have really good penetration when it comes down to Wi-Fi, if you're using Wi-Fi versus some of those machines out there that's made of metal or thicker, harder plastic. So the Wi-Fi connection should have a very stable connection with this one. And for right now, I'm just going to leave this one plugged in through Ethernet until we move it to our next location, and then we'll get it located to the location, and there's really no syncing to go with. And I believe I read something somewhere that the Linxdot should only take about 30 minutes to sync. And on that next video, I'm going to let you know if that is something true. And sometimes people still ask the question, is it loud? Can you hear this thing? Does it take up a lot of energy? Does it take up a lot of Wi-Fi? Things like that. So you're not going to see a lot of big bandwidth pushes with this thing. Whoa, everything just turned red. Don't know what that is about. But that's kind of cool. Anyways, it's not going to take up too much of your Wi-Fi, especially if you have unlimited, which basically everybody has unlimited Wi-Fi at home. Anyways, ooh, this is purple. This is just a light show going on. And so basically, it's not going to take up too much Wi-Fi. It's very, very low bandwidth, so it's not going to really mess anything up. And also, too, it's silent. There's zero sound coming from this thing here. And so, that's also one of the other questions. And it doesn't take a lot of energy. It's usually right around a 5-watt light bulb for the whole year, which is maybe costing you about $2 or $3 for the entire year. So this one's now kind of like a whitish color. I mean, it's kind of cool that they did this. Not any other hotspot is going on with these crazy light shows, but it's pretty fun. And if this is something that kind of bothers you a little bit, if it's too bright at night, don't be afraid to put some black tape over top of this. But just make sure that it's at least a little visible, so then this way you can make sure that it's not, you know, with a red color, just because you want to make sure. Woo! What is... Yeah! Rave. So there you can see that it is syncing. And we do have to update the antenna information. It shows Linxdot and location is null and null all the way up until we would have to move it somewhere. But that is it for today's video and also for this light show. So if you guys are interested in the Linxdot, make sure you guys click the link below the video inside the description. It's my affiliate link. So with me being affiliate, it allows you guys to have a really cool discount code, which is 3%. But if you guys appreciated this video, please give it a big thumbs up. Don't forget to hit subscribe because I will be posting the 2-week earnings of this thing and how it's been doing. So make sure you hit that subscribe button over here on the very bottom left-hand side. And if you like this video, then more than likely you'll also like this video. And I'll see you guys later.